Welcome to Ron Wills Money Matters, Overcoming Bad Credit. Yeah, you know, in a previous episode, I said, you know, I've been at the bottom financially and a lot of people go there. Let's be real. When we get there, our credit get messed up because we be trying to live off that credit card or something. And I'm going to tell you what, even during my best times, let's just say my credit wasn't always good. It's good now. I can get some stuff now. But, you know, it through a variety of reasons, it's been jacked up. Indeed, I will say publicly, I got a couple judgments on my record, but it's deep. It's not on the immediate stuff, but I've had some judgments. That's how bad the credit has been. Credit so bad, shit, I couldn't get regular cars at one time. You know, they be trying to bend over. I had to, like, find those places that don't be looking at credit. One time I had to get a car from one of those buy here, pay here places, which, I'm going to be real, I don't recommend if you can avoid it. But if you got to, you got to, you know. But overcoming it. Now, I know there's plenty of stuff out there about, you know, credit repair and stuff, but I can't really speak on it because I never... You know, when I had that trouble, I had the money to pay for the credit repair. So I was just like, you know, I'm just going to go on and do my thing. But here's the first thing to understand. However your credit get bad, like I said, and I said this in the last one, it could have been a major emergency, medical emergency, or you could just be a spendthrift. However you do it, you know you're in a bad position. The credit score ain't high. It's pretty low. And the reality, so many things involve credit nowadays. I mean, there's certain government jobs you can't get with bad credit. And I'll tell you why that is, certain jobs, because they worried about you being compromised by somebody who finds out about your credit and say, hey, I'll give you a lot of money, but you got to just tell us what's going on here. So that's an issue. So it's like a lot of jobs, if you got bad credit, they won't even let you in there. You know, definitely get a house, car, apartment, everything. Let me just say something on a tangent. Some of that's kind of like forcing you to get credit. Indeed, with a lot of credit cards, they forcing you to spend money. They forcing you to spend money. They say, hey, you could hit them up for a credit thing. You pay your credit good, right? Pay it off, have good credit score. But then you got some companies, if you ask for a higher credit limit, they say, well, you don't really use your card. Which, too, let me real quick say, if you get something, spend maybe $100-something a month or even $50 a month, just pay it off right away. But right now, we're talking about overcoming bad credit. And like I said, I've never had to use one of those credit repair places. So I'm going to be real. I can't personally recommend it. When I recommend stuff, I like to talk about stuff that I'm familiar with. I don't want to just throw it out there. Because, of course, you always got some scams on it. But I'll tell you how I learned to fix it from somebody who's fixed it themselves. Pay off the credit cards. Now, people say how hard that is and everything. And I'm going to tell you what with that. Be careful with the collectors. Be careful with the bill collectors. Because I've read something which said, you know, you can deny it or something. It's a whole bunch of stuff. Really check into that. But I'm going to just say in general, try to pay off your stuff. That's the thing. And just do it well. And even if you got a point where everything's overdrawn right before it gets to credit collections, talk to the people who actually own the card. A lot of times they'll work out something. And here's the thing. Here's a general thing with that. Start with the easiest to pay off first. Even if you come in collections and just still want to pay it anyway. Like I said, that's one of those things. People, there's always like different angles and programs. I'm just going to tell you what I know. What I've done. Pick the easiest one first. And then you pay that off. Put some money into paying that off. And then you just go for the next one and the next one. Now, unfortunately, just the way things are, you still got to have a credit card out here, unfortunately. And unfortunately, there are some credit card companies, if your credit's kind of low or your score is low, they'll hook you up, but they have a fee with it. I tell you what, even with that, if you get one of those with a fee, take it and then do what I said about maybe spend just a little bit of money on it just to, establish that you can pay well. That can help in that manner. So don't spend a lot. Don't get it in, like, go buy, like, those Jordans or that 60-inch TV. You know, get it, spend it on some small stuff, pay it right away just to show it. And that's another way you can help. And then, of course, like I said, you're going to need credit at good credit sometime. And then you do have some credit card companies out there. They don't have, like, extra fees or one of those things like, oh, we'll give you $500 in credit, but you got to pay $100 first. Try to avoid those if you can. But get, like, something. And this can be tough. And like I say, there's some companies out there that'll take a chance on you. You just got to pay it off. You know, just pay it off right away. And then what you did have, just work on it. And that's when you really got to be disciplined, though. Because as you're paying off some of the bad credit cards and then using the new one to reestablish credit, you got to think how you got there at first. Now, if you got there through emergency, that's understandable. But if you got there through being a spendthrift or something and buying extra stuff you didn't really need, And I'm going to tell you the truth. When you talk about credit and all of that, avoid like store credit cards. They charge too much extra. Avoid them. Avoid them as best as possible, you know, and it's just a reality. Like I said, 1,000 reasons can get you in there, but the best way to deal with it is just pay the bill. And I know that sounds simple, and I know some people into some other stuff might, say, well, now you can get them and they'll do this and they'll do that, but they charge you money. Think about it. The easiest way is just to, that's when you really want to manage your money. Manage your money. Think about some of the stuff that you don't need to buy. Put it on getting bad credit cards dealt with. And then having that one credit card, which you can use to reestablish your credit and just buy some little stuff on it. Maybe set a low limit, maybe no more than $25, maybe no more than $50. And pay it off. And one thing, too, about that, too, because most have some type of interest involved, avoid paying the minimum. Avoid paying the minimum. Because that's a little slick trick. Because, yeah, you pay the minimum, but you still got that. Most of them still have that interest. If you can find an interest-free credit card, I think Discover card is interest-free. They should thank me for promoting them. If you can get something like that. If you can get interest-free, that's the best, but that can be tough to find. But if you get one with a little bit of interest, like say the minimum payment is $50, try to give them $100 or at least $25. Never give just the minimum because the little slick thing with the interest, yeah, you paid that minimum, but then you look up after a few months, I'm like, wait a minute, I've been paying this, but I'm owing a little bit more money. Boom. You know, but really work on, like, the payments. Have a plan to deal with each single one. Like I said, I've been in that position before, and the last time I was in that position, I just said, okay, all right. And actually got in there because I was using them for business and everything. And that's one thing about business. You got to use what you got to use. But what I did was I just took them one at a time. Boom, boom, boom. And now I keep one major credit card just to have. Well, no, actually two. I got two, but I only spend money on one. And when I spend money on the other one, I pay it off. Like as soon as it posts, I'm like, it's up. You know, unfortunately, they don't let me just pay it. And that's usually a case where it might be online or something because I'm weird on some sites with using credit card. I'm weird about some sites. So, and I'll keep it small, but it'll be small under $100, somebody can pay off, and I'll pay it off right away, you know. So anyway, though, and like I said, you know, that's Rom's way of looking at it. Let me be clear on that. Like I said, I don't have personal experience using a credit card, pay them off, so I can't recommend, I can't in good conscience, and good integrity recommend something I've never used. They might work, and if you want to go that route, find somebody reputable, that's my word to trip over today, who can help you out. So I can't recommend. It might be a great thing, but I don't know personally. I'm just giving you my way of doing it, okay? So anyway, y'all know the deal, because even to pay off that those credit cards, get that good credit back, you still got to make that money. So let's go make that money. Yeah.